Or an associate of former Trump advisor Roger Stone says he is in plea negotiations with special counsel Robert Mueller. Jerome Corsi is an associate of both President Trump and Roger Stone, and the Mueller team is believed to be looking for any connections between the Trump campaign, between the president and his advisors, and WikiLeaks. I want to bring in CNN senior White House correspondent Pamela Brown. We also have Samantha Vinograd with us. She's a former senior advisor to the National Security Advisor under President Obama. First off, Pamela, as you've been looking into this, what does this mean for the president?
Well, that is the big question. I can tell you the president and his legal team have been waiting to see, Brianna, if anything would happen to Roger Stone or any of his associates, including Jerome Corsi. And now we are learning that Jerome Corsi is in plea talks with the special counsel, which means that there is a potential that he would plead guilty in exchange for leniency. Now, Jerome Corsi said just last week that he expected to be indicted in the investigation for giving false information to Mueller's team or to the grand jury. So clearly, since then, Brianna, it appears that there have been these plea talks. It's unknown what will happen, but we do know that investigators have been looking at whether Jerome Corsi was an intermediary between Roger Stone and WikiLeaks. In fact, Jerome Corsi said in the summer of 2016, he admits that he told associates that he believed WikiLeaks would dump these emails of John Podesta before it happened. And so that has certainly caught investigators' attention. How did he know that? He says it was just a theory based on public sources of information.
It's a theory with a lot of specifics in it. It sort of strains credulity that he just sort of guessed this information that it would be in October. And what else is interesting is he said he shared that prediction, not based from information, but just from his sort of theorizing. He shared it with Roger Stone, he said, but Roger Stone says that he didn't share that information with him. So it seems like this is an important link, right?
It is an important link. And of course, Robert Mueller's investigators have been looking to see if anyone associated with the Trump campaign, including Jerome Corsi, had advanced knowledge of what WikiLeaks was going to do. And so the fact that he told associates well before the October document dump that this could happen certainly has raised eyebrows. Now, Jerome Corsi, for his part, has said, well, this was a theory based on the fact that when WikiLeaks revealed the DNC emails, as you'll recall, that were hacked that summer, they didn't include John Podesta. So I was just piecing it together that eventually they would likely release John Podesta's emails. That is what he has told other media outlets. But certainly, Robert Mueller's team is very interested in this. And the fact that they are now in plea negotiations is clearly a big development. Of course, that could still fall apart. Just because they're in talks doesn't mean those talks could end.
Sure, and they've gone back and forth with Corsi, it's worth pointing out. Sam, when you look at this, what does this tell you about where the Mueller investigation may be headed?
Well, Brianna, it certainly tells me that the Mueller investigation is going full steam ahead, but it's important to remember why Jerome Corsi signing a plea deal is so important. The intelligence community concluded 2 years ago, almost 2 years ago in January, that the Russian government at Vladimir Putin's behest laundered information through third parties and WikiLeaks to discredit President Secretary Clinton and to help President Trump. So when I look at this news, my first question is, who else knew what Jerome Corsi may have known? Did he know and did he work directly with WikiLeaks when this information was coming out? Was he the missing link in this case? And who else had that information? Did Roger Stone know, for example, that Jerome Corsi had any advance warning, if Jerome Corsi did, about the information that was about to become public? And then, of course, Bob Mueller would have to look at whether President Trump had any advance warning as well. So the first question is, was whether Jerome Corsi was a missing link in some way between the Russians and this information dump? And then second, who else had that information and actively participated in the laundering of information to discredit a presidential candidate?
And I just want to say, on Sam's note, one of the questions to the president and the recent batch of questions from Robert Mueller's team was whether Roger Stone had told him about the WikiLeaks and the fact that they would release John Podesta's email. So we know that's been of interest to Mueller's team. Now, the president and his legal team denied they had any advanced knowledge, but what is interesting is there was a delay in returning the responses to Mueller's questions because the legal team wanted to see if anything would happen on the Roger Stone front or any of his associates.
That is very interesting. Pamela Brown, Sam Vinograd, thank you to both of you.